Hello, you're watching Dukascopy TV, and joining me here today is Alan McQuaid, who is Chief Economist with Merrion Capital, an Irish financial services firm. Today, we're looking at the Eurozone's PMI figures, which were released today. The Eurozone has been in recession for the last year and a half, but figures today show that manufacturing output in the Eurozone improved in June to a 16-month high. How big of a signal is this that the economy is stabilising?
Well, I think it's encouraging after a few months of weak numbers and indications that the economy is in recession. I think what's really encouraging is the fact that countries like Spain are showing sort of major signs of improvement. And clearly, they're benefiting from the fact that they've implemented changes in terms of becoming more competitive. I think you look at the overall sort of state of play in the world economy, I think it does seem now that China will become a bigger issue for financial markets rather than Europe in the second half of the year.
Okay, and German manufacturing activity actually contracted for the fourth consecutive month in June, coming in below expectations at 48.6. Should this be cause for concern?
Well, I think this probably reflects the fact that most other countries in the Eurozone have been sort of implementing measures to, through fiscal austerity, etc., and becoming more competitive, and Germany has effectively stood still. So I think there is a warning sign for the Eurozone's largest economy that it can't afford to rest on its laurels. It needs to, make sure that it's competitive too. But I think in the overall scheme of things, given that Germany is the biggest economy in the region, that's obviously going to have implications for, monetary policy and how the ECB perceives things going forward.
We are beginning to see stronger PMIs for Spain and for Italy. Does this mean that these countries are starting to recover?
Well, I think it's a start. I mean, is it enough? Probably not. I think Spain is probably doing more than Italy in terms of becoming more competitive. I think the problem that these countries have, particularly Spain, is the huge level of unemployment, and that's the key thing going forward. Hopefully, these better PMI numbers will feed through into lower rates of unemployment going forward. But, given that a country like Spain that, was one in two youths unemployed and unemployment as a whole, almost running at 30%, a lot more needs to be done. But, you can't deny the fact that it's got to start somewhere, and these numbers do suggest that at least it's making inroads and going in the right direction.
And finally, do you think that these signs of stabilisation will ease pressure on the ECB to expand monetary policy to boost growth?
No, I think what the ECB will do, I think they'll acknowledge the fact that some of the numbers in relation to some of the countries are getting better. But I think they will stick to their mantra of, keeping policy easy for the foreseeable future. I mean, clearly at the moment, a lot of the focus is on Portugal with the political turmoil there. And that's probably going to be the main focus of attention tomorrow at the press conference. But I think the central bank is well aware that things are so fraught, both, at home and abroad, that it cannot afford to relax on the monetary policy front. So I think it will maintain a dovish bias for the foreseeable future.
Okay, and that's all we have time for today, Mr. McQuaid. We'll have to leave it there, but thank you for joining me. Bye for now.